Hello, Patrick Walchuk here, and we're filming this basically at the end of April of 2024. And as you may be aware, the federal government brought down a new budget very, very recently. And one of the elements of that budget was a change to capital gains taxation. And I just wanted to highlight this to you. And if you go to the next slide, what we'll do is show you where it is and where the budget is taking it. And this won't just affect investors, but if you're somebody who is thinking of becoming an investor, will affect you. If you're somebody who owns your own home and maybe you own a cottage, maybe you own a small condominium somewhere as a little bit of investment money coming in for you, this will affect you. It will have an effect on a lot of people. So let's start off with where capital gains is now. So currently, if you sell a property and you're going to be charged capital gains, you pay taxes on the first 50% of your profit, okay? So if you sell something for $100, you pay tax only on the first 50 bucks. The other 50%, you don't pay any tax, okay? Simple as that. So that's how it is right now. So on June 25th, what's going to change is that you pay 50% tax on the first $250,000 profit you make, okay? So you sell something for $300,000, only on the first $250,000, you pay that 50%. On the remainder, on any of the profit, over $250,000, you're now going to be taxed at 66.67%. So you're gonna have to pay more. If you're a corporation, and I deal with a lot of people who have incorporated themselves. You know, they buy a few buildings and they put it in the names of the corporation. Well, their capital gains is going to change as well. And what's different about a corporation than an individual is that from dollar one, the first dollar that you make as a profit on your sale, you're going to be taxed at 66.67%. So let me give you a real quick history of capital gains. So there were no capital gains until 1972. Then the government introduced them and it was at the rate of 50%. And then in 88, that was increased to 66.67%. Then in 1990, it was increased to 75%. That's how much tax you would have paid back then. And then in the year 2000, 24 years ago, a quarter of a century ago, it was decreased down to this 50%. And that was because our finance minister, Paul Martin, what he wanted to do is he wanted to give investors motivation to take risks and reward people for taking those risks. And when they sold the property, they could realize more of a profit. So that was part of the reason why Paul Martin decreased that. So right now, we're almost punishing people who are taking a risk and who are successful. And I just want to point out one more thing before we move on, is that currently, self-employed Canadians are down 7% from pre-pandemic times. So if you're self-employed and you can maybe make a little bit of money on capital gains thing, well, there's fewer of you guys out there by 7%. Okay, let's move on to the next slide. GDP per individual in Canada is down. We're just being less productive overall. So this chart here, this will show you what is going on. So even if the government tells you GDP is up or whatever, let me read you this. Canada's economic output on a per capita basis has slipped to 7% below its long-term trend, amounting to a decline of roughly $4,200 per person, according to a report published Wednesday by Statistics Canada. And by the way, this is a key indicator of our household living standards. So basically, we're getting poorer. Per capita, we're getting poorer. Okay. Now, let's take a look at why this is really an insult. So the insult to me, anyhow, is that the person who took the risks and has to pay capital gains, they took all that risk on money that has already been taxed, okay? So you got some guy who buys a little bungalow and he wants to put an apartment in the basement, an SDU. So he spends his money that he's already been taxed on to go out and buy that bungalow. All right. So he's taking the risk that he can rent it. He's going through all the work that's involved. When he's buying materials to build that SDU in the basement, he's paying HST on all those materials. The tradespeople he's hiring, he's paying those guys HST. So when it's all done and he sells it, he's now got to pay a higher, no, you don't, that's okay, it's okay, but he's now got to pay that higher 66.67%. And that's because the government has now come along, who has taken none of the risks to our investors, and the government is saying, you dirty little capitalist, we'll teach you to risk your own money and actually expect to keep it. So we need to tax you so we can do things like buy really cool Arrive Canada apps. Right? So anyhow, I'm going to stop there, but I'm not in fond of the increase in capital gains. Thanks for watching.